So I wanted to ask you this question, is why after 40 days you have given this? So then don't you think you should have given it when the mediation panel was happening? Isn't this a contradictory stand?
No, it is not like that. Mediation can happen at any point of time. There is no contradiction in it. When the hearings were going on, hearing can go on simultaneously, and the mediation can go outside the courtroom, and it did happen here, and Honorable Supreme Court has allowed that to happen. So therefore, there is no contradiction in that.
Doesn't it weaken the stand of the UP Sunni Waqf Board, because the Babri Masjid was demolished? So ideally, the fair position is that the masjid should be built.
Whatever argued inside the court are the legal arguments, and where the parties are entitled, and we did try our best, the other side also tried their best to argue in the best possible manner to safeguard their interest, and this is exactly what has happened. Outside the court, when you sit across the table, then you don't go into the legalities, then you look at it from a different perspective, keeping in view those issues which are which you do not consider, cannot take while you are arguing a case. So therefore, they are strictly legal. One party wins or loses. In fact, what has happened in this case, the talk of negotiations had happened even prior to demolition of Babri Masjid. Number of times, many efforts were made, but unfortunately, somehow or the other, it failed. Thereafter, in Ismail Farooqi also, the court had expressed its hope that the parties, this case is the most imminent to be decided not inside the court, but to be settled outside the court between the parties, among the parties, and by sitting across the table. So therefore, keeping that spirit in mind, the mediators had in fact gone on, and Honorable Supreme Court had in fact appointed this mediation panel, despite the fact that some parties did not want at that point of time. But they say even 1% chance is there, we will go for that. And that chance we took, and we are very positive and hopeful that inshallah this settlement will go through, and it will bring a sea change in this country.
And also, as a part of the mediation panel, you said there was UP Sunni Waqf Board and the Hindu parties, but Nirmohi Akhada had already said that they are not going to be a part of the any mediation. So essentially, it is a Hindu Mahasabha and Nyas. So are all of them in
the... I tell you, I won't disclose the name who
were
there, but there were appellants, who were main appellants here from Hindu side.
And you say Hindu side, there are so many Hindu sides.
No, there are only 6 appeals from Hindu side,
so,
and eight appeals from Muslim side. But they are not 8 appellants. They are, one person had filed 2 appeals. Suppose I had filed 2 appeals. The others have also filed one or two appeals. So therefore, in total, I think from Muslim side, there were 5 appellants, out of which Sunni board was the main appellant.
Yes.
And their appeal is the main appeal, and their suit was because they were the lead, and they the suit has been declared to be a representative suit of the entire Muslim community. So therefore, they were the main. And they had taken a call and discussed the issue and come to certain settlement terms and agreed to that.
So the
both the parties had agreed.
So other than Nirmohi Akhada, the others are there, is that?
That I can't say. Nirmohi Akhada today may say no.
But
tomorrow
they have been consistently saying.
They may come tomorrow, I don't know. Parties may change stand. They can change after looking into the circumstances. We do change every day.
Okay.
So
and
good sense will prevail.
Is the because there have been reports that there have been cases slapped against Mr. Farooqi by the UP government and the CBI. You think it's an arm twisting method?
I do not want to get into that.
So you
don't
agree
want to
that
spoil the spirit of the settlement by making all these.
So the UP government under Ajay Bisht is not.
I'm not.
So there's no arm twisting.
I do not even know that.
So it's not on Mr. Farooqi's personal appeal. Is this Mr. Farooqi's personal appeal?
I say it cannot be his personal appeal. It is board.
But the board did not meet for the in under Waqf board. They were board should meet first.
Who
said decide.
So? How
the,
do you know?
Isn't it the rule?
Mr. Farooqi cannot come on his own. He is one of the members of the board.
He's a chairman.
If he comes, the chairman does not mean that you are all in all. you go by the board. It is board. Board means, board is represented by chairman, that's all. But the board is a statutory body. It has a number of members who all would have agreed to whatever is done. So therefore it is board.
And there is
Faruqi Saab and board. So he appeared for board.
Okay.
As chairman of the board, he is the authority, legal authority.
And there is no for pressure from the UP government to settle this
that
case?
I am nobody to comment. I don't know why these questions are being asked.
Because yesterday on Twitter, there
people can
thing.
Say anything, no?
There is a CBI
Let
case.
Let us look at the positive side that the settlement is there. And that settlement term is going to be the for the betterment of the country.
Is it that?
Look at from that point of view.
Is it that all ASI mosques should be taken under the control of the government?
I cannot comment on that also.